Hey, I'm Alan, and this is Brian from the Black Dahlia murder.
He's true. We are both these people.
And you're with T.I.S. The truth is scary.
Too scary for most.
Your source for alternative news and celebrity views. It's truthisscary.com. Log on and be aware.
All right, guys, let's start right off. Hey, do you believe in UFOs, aliens? Do you think we've been visited by extraterrestrials in the past and they may even have an influence on our history?
What do you think, Brian?
Look at Egypt, man. Shit's crazy.
I have heard some interesting things about Egypt. Like, I was just reading a book recently that was talking about how the Sphinx is actually more weathered than the rest of the pyramids are. And they were saying that to get to the condition that it's in right now, there would have to be like 1,000 years of continual rain being poured on it, because it was like a lot of rain weathering going on. And they think that the Sphinx is actually, I want to say, like 14,000 years old rather than like 4,000, I think, is what they thought initially. But, I mean, and then there's just the pyramids in Mexico and all that stuff, and it's just like those blocks are so precisely cut, and it's like everybody says nobody had technology like that back then that could do that kind of stuff. And so it's just like, I mean, I think we kind of went into a downward spiral somewhere along the way, and we're all idiots now.
Making our pyramids.
Yeah. But makes sense to me.
Right?
Well, maybe we've had a reset in the world and we forgot. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
All right, here's another one. Do you think now with the creation of artificial intelligence that there really is a possibility that we could create robots that could rise up against and destroy the human race like the Terminator?
I've also read about this, a lot of people are saying that it's not possible. It's like, they'll kind of just have it in their programming that they can't hurt people, and that, like, it would basically be like Terminator would go against their programming or whatever.
Yeah, but watch fucking, like, a dude like Tsarnaev or whatever, you know, he got a little bit of programming on him. He gets on a computer and he's like, I program you to go down to, you know, the Sunday social and blow everyone away. So yeah, I think the robots could come, because it's going to come from a bad egg, a bad human. That's what I think.
Like a virus?
Oh yeah.
Well, speaking of that, do you think a zombie apocalypse is possible?
I haven't heard much evidence of that. Whole lot of fantasy out there, but until Uncle Maury wakes up, I don't believe in it.
I think a 28 days later scenario is probably more likely than a reanimation of the dead. But I guess there's
a rage virus that could happen.
I think I've heard that there's some sort of virus that actually causes animals to like start turning against one another and just getting crazy. I mean, it's not rabies, it's something else, but like they just go nuts and start like killing everything around them. But I think that's more plausible.
Here's a simple one. Do you guys think, well, you know, we have Washington State, Colorado, and a lot of states doing medical marijuana. Do you think marijuana is something that should finally be legalized, and, you know, are there actual benefits to it?
Unless we're going to make some other sort of super industry, something that's going to make dollars just happen like that already is, but we're not taxing it. So, I mean, that'd be great. I challenge the geniuses of America to, you know, make a monorail that can get me from Chicago to San Francisco in 2 hours. If you can do that, I don't need pot quite as much.
I say yes and yes to that question.
Okay. How about psychedelics? Do you think they can expand and expand your mind and help you achieve higher consciousness and possibly help and enhance your life?
I think so. I think
on how much you use, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's all about moderation. But
probably narrow your life spectrum if you just did it all the damn time.
Yeah, I don't have 8 hours a day to devote to being out of my mind. But
any thoughts you'll never remember that were so groovy?
Forgot how to use a pen when I was high. No, but I did do DMT, and that is definitely the drug. Yeah, I mean, like, it's natural. You're not gonna get hurt. It's actually very relaxing. I was freaked out when I first tried it, but I almost had a near spiritual experience. And as I was like starting to really get into the trip, my ceiling was crumbling away, and a buddy of mine who was sitting in the room with me was like 20 at the time, and he's balding and he has like a horseshoe on his head, and I saw Vishnu in my ceiling, but then it was ruined because my friend's face was on his head. I have no idea why, but I thought it was pretty funny.
Hey, I wanted to tell you, right here, right now, I felt like you were going to ask me if we wanted to time travel and where we would go. I went back to just now.
Dude, how did you know I was going to ask you that question?
You did already.
Answer. You just did. This
guy's how about that? It's possible. I did it. No, but I would also go back to probably, I would say when, you know, the Wings swept those avalanchers probably a month before that, put some money down, be on a boat right now doing this interview with you.
Definitely back to
Wouldn't
the future, too.
Would you rather
too.
Be on a boat?
Absolutely. Sweating my ball up in here.
Let's get some of that open breeze.
Absolutely.
How about you? Where would you go?
Where are you going to go in time?
Where would I go back in time, man? Can I go to the future? Because I would definitely go to the future. I mean, the past is cool, but like, I want to see what's coming up next. Get a, you know,
you head see start the robots, on things. Get programmed to hurt.
Yeah, and then I will come back and I'll tell you that this is a bad idea and that we need to stop it now.
Right. Well, somebody should have done that. Okay, one real quick music question. Where do you guys derive your inspiration from? Where do you find you get most of your inspiration from your music, for your music?
Alan, no, most of my influences come from all sorts of different stuff. I don't know. I like a lot of different types of music. There's little bits and pieces of everything that can fit inside this sound of death and destruction. Where you come from?
That's pretty much the same here. I mean, like, I try to listen to a bunch of, you know, different metal and stuff and take, like, cool parts from everything I've listened to and I don't know. So anything heavy and extreme really influences me, I guess.
Cool. All right, one more. What do you think the world would be like without money?
I think we'd still trade pebbles.
Yes, definitely. I feel like there'd be some kind of a currency system. I know that there was this thing called the Venus Project a while ago where it was just service-based.
Resource-based economy.
Yeah, resource-based economy. But then it's still the problem of, like, hey, this guy's got to come over and fix my roof. He said he was going to do it, and he probably will do it, but he's still not here, and it's been 6 hours since he said he was going to do it. So it's like, what kind of incentive do you have besides just being, like, a good person and trying to pay it forward all the time? Like, that's unfortunately what I feel like is the problem with that whole scenario.
I got you. How about you?
Are you allowed to masturbate at one of these facilities?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
See the problem.
Cool. All right, guys, that's all I got for you, man. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Truth is scary.